Too many people go to therapy because of what others want them to do, whether it is the right thing for them or not. But how do you listen to yourself first, without feeling the need for other people's approval and validation? In this video, we will discuss the most likely roots of people's need for validation coming from their family members and their relationship with them. We will try to understand what makes family members want to guide or control so much of people's life and how they can address it and move on. Let's get right into today's topic. So why is it indeed that what you do is so important to someone else, especially family members, that sometimes they take their advice and guidance a bit too far? Let us start with the most likely reason of all. They genuinely do care about you and love you. They want you to do well and be happy and to avoid repeating their mistakes. They just want to teach you early what they have learned late. So in effect, they're just overprotective of you. But they may have grown up in different times, culture, and even political regime. And they may be conditioned to think that just sucking it up and listening to authority should work for this generation too. This is why their mind registers their misunderstood, overpowering guidance as the right way or sometimes as the only way in which they can help you. This is a typical example of a generational clash. They may even fear that they are not doing a good job as a parent or relative, and they may feel ashamed of it and try to hide it, which is why they may want you to hide your coping mechanisms as well. And we also have to admit that many times we also bring back home anxiety from outside, especially at an early age, when we are more vulnerable and unable to set healthy boundaries. Our school and social circle in the media can affect us much more than our family members are affected by external circumstances. Of course, even they cannot leave outside of the home everything that life has put on their shoulders, and they bring at least some baggage back home as well. All this can create tensions. We can recognize that this is nothing more than a generational clash, and your family members do want what's best for you. When there is no competition, over-dramatization, self-victimization, and blaming towards you. If you disagree with them on what you should do in your own life, try to approach the conversation with understanding and love. For example, you could tell them, "Mom, Dad, Aunt, Uncle, I love you and I want you to be happy. I'm sure you want me to be happy too. We want the same thing, just in a different way. My way is through." Then say what you have chosen to do. The fact that I cannot apply your way to my life now doesn't mean that I don't believe you or that I disrespect you. I'm just working with what I can and what I have right now. I'm learning a lot from you. Please know that I hear what you're saying and I'm putting it in storage to use and apply in the future. But for now, my way is through. Say again what you have chosen to do. In this way, you express your gratitude and you help them realize that their role is not to control your life even for your own good, but to ensure a safe and healthy environment for you to find your own thing. But if you face continuous criticism from family members despite all your efforts, and especially if this criticism is accompanied by their competition, over-dramatization, self-victimization, and blaming towards you, then it may be helpful for you to stop taking on any blame that they put on you. That is not for you to carry, because they need to learn their own lesson of humility, acceptance of others, and unconditional love. The root cause of their controlling behavior may be that this person just has a difficult character. However, many times such a character has been augmented by circumstances in their own past, and by important relationships with others, especially their beloved ones. For example, if they have been the least favored child out of the siblings in their own family, and they have witnessed their parents' preference towards the other sibling. Or if they have been a neglected child, an abandoned child, a pressured child, or a bullied child or a youngster. Such a child or youngster may grow into an adult who transfers their need for the love that they have not received in the past onto others in the present. Those other people in the present are expected to compensate for that past love that this adult in question has not received, in addition to giving them their own love. This could also be the case for a divorced parent who subconsciously expects their child to compensate for the love of their partner who has left. In rare cases, such an adult might idolize the person or people who have disappointed them because the reality is too painful to admit to themselves, which on the other hand enhances their demands for appreciation, praise, and even obedience from others. As a result, what such an adult perceives as a proof of love may never be enough, and your efforts to meet this need are likely to exhaust you or to make you feel like you yourself are never enough. It is not the final result of your efforts that they're seeking. It is the effort itself that makes them feel important because you constantly seek their approval or validation. Consequently, they will never give you their full approval or gratitude, and they will make you strive for that little bit more that they need from you. If you are a child or a dependent of such an adult, what they need from you might include you going down a predetermined path and fulfilling those dreams of theirs that for one reason or another have been out of reach for them to achieve. If you have not been successful at fulfilling their dream purely because your own path and life purpose are different, they may remind you and hold you accountable for their sacrifice, efforts, and investment in you, and for the praise and success that you owe them according to them. Have you ever blamed yourself, or have you been blamed for not fulfilling the expectations of some of your family members? Let me know down in the comments. The paradox is that they may start competing with you once you're on the verge of success, because in the past they have competed with others for the love and appreciation of someone important to them, and competition comes naturally to them. Even more surprisingly, they may still love you in their own way without realizing completely what they're doing, because their motives for it are coming from their subconscious. And when you bring it up, they could still blame you for being disrespectful to them. So when did you stop listening to your inner voice first? And when did you start doubting yourself? You may have been helped a little bit by those who want to exercise control over your choices and actions. After all, if you believe in yourself and listen to yourself first, you stop listening to them and stop giving them the validation that either their ego or their love-deprived inner child needs. How can they undermine your belief in yourself? By constantly telling you that your reasoning is wrong, your fear and worries are exaggerated, your opinion is ungrounded, and your experience is insufficient, usually compared to theirs, which is why you should rely on their ample experience and knowledge that is applicable in any situation and culture and age. Also, by constantly reminding you how your self-esteem should be based on the notion of their achievements and on the path that they have illuminated for you. In effect, everything that is external to you and involves them in some way should be the source of your self-esteem and your self-worth, according to them. Which is not how this works. If you have been or you are in a similar situation as the child of such an adult, regardless of your age, know that true self-esteem and self-worth come from within you, from how happy you are with your own nature, character, values, choices, aspirations, and dreams, from believing in your own decisions and not questioning yourself when you make a move, from loving yourself in all of your craziness and even mood swings and mistakes that build your character, from hugging your body and appreciating that it is your shrine and it keeps you alive, regardless of its size or ability, from exploring life and building your own experience without a feeling of guilt that you are not fulfilling someone else's dream or you're not successful at their dream, from your creativity that comes with this newfound freedom. People see others through their own lens, so external validation is not the best reflection of your true self. It is to a great extent a reflection of the other person themselves. Seeking validation from others is like asking them to look through eyes that they don't have, your eyes. Know your true self, don't be ashamed of it in any way, and don't be afraid to show it and enjoy it. Your direction is onwards and upwards, not back to the past, and not in a circle or a loop around someone else whose validation you seek, or vice versa, someone who craves your attention, validation, and obedience as a proof of love. If a grown-up, able and capable family member tries to persuade you that it is your duty and responsibility to do as they say, otherwise they're the victim and you're being disrespectful, ungrateful, or anything else they choose to name you, just look ahead and keep moving forward. Don't believe their version of you, because such people may want you to dislike yourself even more than they already dislike themselves. This is how they keep their upper hand. Instead of allowing them to trigger you, approach the situation with humor. Oh, poor him or her being so far away from reality while also being unable to defeat their own ego. Forgive your family for not being able to love you the way you needed them to. After that, forgive yourself for searching for love from the wrong people. You are fully capable of breaking the toxic chain and passing on healing and love. There is only one of you, and your love is enough in whichever way you choose to express it. You cannot compensate for the love of anyone else, even if you exhaust yourself trying. You cannot give additional love in place of someone else's patriarchal parent, or unappreciative relative, or bullying classmate, or cheating partner, or non-caring spouse. You are unique, and you are enough. Listen to your inner voice first, trust yourself, be brave, focus, take the next step towards that thing that you truly want, take calculated risks, don't give up, and love yourself. If you are getting value now, please like, share, subscribe, and hit that bell button to get notified when I post a new video. Check out my other videos and let me know down in the comments if you would like to hear more on this topic or any other topics, because I care about what's important to you.